Hey guys, Jason here from Timberfalls, home for CNC creators like you. In today's video, we're going to be revisiting the Vector Doctor tool. If you follow the channel, you'll know we recently released a video on Vector Doctor, and I got a bunch of feedback from that video. It was brought to my attention that there were some things that we missed and a couple of things we didn't explain well. So we're going to re-release this video to help clear things up. Hopefully by the end of this, you'll have a great understanding of the Vector Doctor tool that's in Carveco. With that said, let's get started. I've imported this vector of this airport police badge, and we're going to use the Vector Doctor to fix any issues that we may have. The Vector Doctor is located up at the top bar by this green cross. Once the Vector Doctor opens, the first thing we have at the top is our tolerance. Or curve tolerance. What a tolerance is how closely the program is going to follow a particular vector. Try and think of tolerance as how accurately it's going to actually follow or how accurately it's going to look for issues. The bigger the tolerance, the more issues it will find because it's not following the vectors close enough. The second section down is to select a specific vector. This section is actually quite powerful. It helps you find any kind of open vectors that may be in your design. When I clicked the open vectors button, it didn't highlight anything. We didn't have any open vectors in this design. But when I click the closed vectors, you can see that it highlights all of the closed vectors in our vector design. We also have a duplicates button that will help you find any kind of duplicates that may be in your vector. You also can highlight which vectors run clockwise and which vectors run anti-clockwise. This can help when you're cutting it out to know which direction that the tool is going to be going. The next four buttons down allow you to find either a closed vector or a vector by length or size. This can be helpful when you're trying to find super tiny vectors that may be cluttering up your design. And you can see that when I press the closed vector smaller than 0.0001, we actually found a couple of very small vectors in this design. Now to remove those, I'm just going to press delete on the keyboard and that's going to get rid of them. And you can keep moving this up to try and find even larger ones. Let's try 0.001. And that found all of these small vectors in our design. Depending on whether you want to keep those or not and how it may affect your design. The next section down is our identify problem section. And generally you're going to have two types of problems. We have coincidence nodes or coincidence points and vector intersections. A coincidence node or coincidence points are two points or two nodes that are closer together than our given tolerance. I'm going to turn off vector intersections just so we can look at coincidence nodes or coincidence points. So when we press identify, it's going to show us all of our coincidence nodes that are closer than this 0.001. The whole point of the coincidence nodes is to show you where you may have particular issues in machining or things that are not going to machine because of how close they are to each other. While coincidence nodes are a helpful tool, they are not necessary in order to machine this relief. These are just places that probably aren't going to machine perfectly, but still going to carve this. It's a good practice to set these tolerances to the tolerances that you're going to use in your toolpathing, and that'll kind of give you an idea of things that are not going to come out exactly the way that they look in the drawings. The other kind of problem that we're going to have is vector intersections. When I click vector intersections and click identify, we're going to get these other circles. Now, in previous videos, I had explained that the coincidence nodes were red and that the vector intersections were green. But what it actually means is the red circles are vector problems within the same vector, and green circles are problems within two different vectors. Red circles show vector loops generally because these are issues that are within the same vector. And that leads us to our last section, the fix problems. Now, the Vector Doctor can try and automatically fix vector loops, by clicking this Remove Vector Loops checkbox. And we're going to pick 100% because we don't want any vector loops. And a vector loop out of 100% would be a loop around the project. We click Fix Problems. And this is going to attempt to fix all of our minor vector loop issues that may be within our design. Some of these are really hard to see. When we clear our markers and we identify again, let's turn off our coincidence nodes, clear markers, and identify again. We fixed all of our vector loop issues. And the only thing we're left with are our vector intersections. And it looks like most of these are with two different vectors overlapping each other. Now, to fix this, you would simply just either move one of these vectors or delete the inside one. It looks like most of these can just be moved around. I hope this breakdown of the Vector Doctor has been a little more helpful. If there's anything we missed, leave it in the comments below. Huge thanks to our Timberfalls Elite members, Richard Shark, Scott Peekney, Philip Perks, and Harry Bieber from Black Nickel Designs. You folks keep the bit spinning, and we're incredibly grateful for your support. Thinking about joining the Elite? Click the join button here on YouTube or head over to my website, timberfalls.us, for more details. Until next time, let's keep crafting, keep sharing, and let's make bit happen. See you on the next one.